And Sardar RP Singh, please touch your heart and tell us, aren't you feeling far more happy today than on 4th of June 2024?
Well, there's no doubt in that, Anand, but where Mr. Mehta's left, I'll like to pick up the stick from there. Mr. Mehta, you rightly said, BJP is a different party, and then with Amit Shah's presidentship, the party has built up a new structure, which is called Panna Pramukh, which is called Tridev, which is called polling booth in charge, which is called Shakti Kendra, and which is called Mandal, then district, and then the state. So this complete machinery works around the year. It's not that they work in during election. Every month we have must go for a monkey bath. So each Panna Pramukh means at a polling station, minimum 6 or 8 Panna Pramukh will hold monkey bath in their pockets with 10 to 12 people or 15 people minimum at their residence or the conductor program, different residence, and then put that on a several app as a program done. This is just one. There are minimum 4 to 5 programs which every Panna Pramukh does every month, and I'm part of it myself, although being a spokesperson. I conduct the same activity at polling booth number 17 in Rajendranagar. So this machinery is undoubtedly a machinery which no one can beat.
Give me a second.
Allow me to complete and then you complete your question. And also the narrative part and also the leadership part. I mean, all this add up to that Panna Pramukh, that machinery that gives special push to that machinery.
So, but would you also agree, very sir, I'm interrupting you, 400 par mein overconfidence tha, 46 par mein humility thi.
And
that's where the effort made a difference.
No. 400 par mein overconfidence nahi tha. Panna Pramukh ne tab bhi kaam kiya, 400 par mein narrative garbada gaya. Wo narrative ko encash kar liya Congress ne, ye kya karke 400 par karenge, samvidhan badlenge, aur ek certain vote bank ko touch kar liya. They could manage certain vote bank and they could touch the core of certain vote bank.
But what change, RP Singh saab, you know, directionally in politics, agar hawa ek taraf ja rahi hai, the hawa tends to go more in that direction. When the hawa changes, something substantial has to have happened between the last 3 months. What happened in June which did not happen now, or what happened now which could not happen in June? Kuch to hua hoga.
No, as I was telling, June was also good. Our cadre was also well geared up. Everything was well in system. Only thing is that narrative of 400 par turned into a negative narrative for us, as if we are going to change the constitution. That led to touch the core of certain vote bank which voted against us, keeping in mind that if they come to power with 400 member parliament, they'll change the constitution. So we are accepting that. But the cadre is charged. I'll appreciate. Do a story on this sometime, that how do the BJP cadre works on ground day after day, and how do that, please go through the
cadre works when they work together with the RSS, sir. 16,000 village sabhas over 6,000 villages in Haryana, that perhaps is the difference. You've also been very closely working with the RSS to Lokesh Jindal, coming to you after this. Good evening.
Give me a second. Anand, give me a second. I'm the same man who goes to Shaka in the morning, recite my morning prayer, do my my activity there, say Namaste Sada Vaste Matru Bhumi. In daytime, I work for BJP. And in evening, I work for one more section of the RSS, which is related to Sikh organization system. So it's the same man, same cadre. There's no difference between, I mean, don't distinguish between that. There's a different cadre who works for RSS, there's a different cadre who works for BJP. The cadre is same.
So then Nadda ji ne kyun kaha ki bina RSS ke saksham hai?
You know, I don't know how it was manipulated, how it turned out. I read the interview. I mean, that was a twist of a tongue or a turn of a page or a turn of a narrative. But fact is, that there is no difference between RSS and BJP at all. I mean,
take this forward. You know, the two states, clearly, I think the reason why there's an energy change is the BJP also, privately, you will say this, that, you know, you're not expecting to win Haryana. And on the other side, the Congress was saying 50 ho jayega, 55 ho jayega, 60 ho jayega. Clearly, that is not what the people of Haryana were thinking. So the energy change is because of the sudden nature of this result. The people have said that, look, you can't take us for granted. But I want to take it forward, and I want to ask our panelists here, as well as you know, Lokesh Jindal and the political guests who are joining us, what does this mean going forward? What does this mean going into Maharashtra? What does this mean going into into Jharkhand, and possibly even what does this mean going into the Delhi election early next year? So let's start with Rashid Kidwai.
Yeah, so I think this Panna Pramukhs and that kind of thing has always been there. It was there in 2013 elections of Delhi, 2020 elections, 15 election, 20 elections. So it happens. Panna Pramukhs do their job. All political parties, political activists do their job. It is that outcome that determines everything. I think, the Congress story has gone horribly wrong in Haryana, but that doesn't mean that, it will be a repetition in Maharashtra and in Delhi and in Bihar, etc. There is a saying that if you have a hot plate of khichdi and if you put your hand in the middle, it's going to burn. So you have to eat it from the side. So the Congress has to have, help of NCP, as in Uttar Pradesh Lok Sabha elections we saw Samajwadi Party, Mamata Banerjee. The Congress has to take this, India story, India Alliance story forward rather than the Congress story.
No, but this was, Haryana was a straight fight. Here the Congress was the lead party and the face was this one. Now, Lokesh Jindal, how would you look at it? Do you think that if the overconfidence hurt the BJP in Lok Sabha elections, it's hurt the Congress party in Haryana?
In Haryana, if we look at the outcome, we see in rural areas, Congress performed well.
Yes.
In urban areas, it is BJP which was able to perform well. If you talk about southern Haryana region like the Rewari and the Nuh area, and then further on the Jhajjar side as well as Kaithal, and then the central of Haryana area, which is more rural and agricultural base, over there Congress gained subsequent gains. Exactly. Over there. But then with respect to the rural areas, in fact, Panchkula was a major disappointment for BJP, where Gyan Chand Gupta lost and the Congress candidate won, but rest other places BJP won on the urban area. So I see that Congress could have done better if it would have had some form of planning and reach to the urban areas as well.
So, Mr. Jindal, I'm not sure that what you say adds up.